Weather Lab. Here's Rob's forecast.
Welcome back. Well, starting to feel and look like fall out there. Justin Taro getting this nice shot. Some fall colors in the background. Nice breeze and some scattered showers across the area. We'll get to that in just a bit. But not a bad day out there if you don't mind temperatures holding in the 60s. And a lot of us don't mind that after the long, hot summer. Meanwhile, back to the west, it's still more rainfall across Texas. They've been stuck in this overrunning pattern. Upper level low out here in the west, keeping the subtropical jet stream busy. And it's also kept the cloud cover locked in across our part of the world. Our frontal boundaries out in the Gulf of Mexico, where showers and thunderstorms persist, and we do have some scattered showers inland, but the trend over the next day or two will be for fewer showers. Another front though on the way this weekend, but we're not looking at a definitive line of showers and storms, but some scattered showers more than likely following the front going into Saturday late and into Saturday night. Now, as we take a look at what's going on right now, we are seeing showers and some heavier showers, especially across portions of Acadia Parish, mainly north of I-10 up through the Church Point area, with more showers off to the north and east. Heaviest activity just north of I-10 now, just east of the Iota area. Activity moving to the north. You can see Church Point getting some nice little rainfall, and it'll be raining shortly in Eunice, probably in the next few minutes. It's raining over toward Lawtell. We move it over toward Opelousas and the Port Barry area. We see that rainfall from about the Sunset area along I-49 near Opelousas, west side of town, certainly going to get wet, and then scattered activity a little bit lighter as you go farther to the east, and a little bit of a shower between Leonville and Port Barry. That's also moving to the northwest. So with that, temperatures holding in the 60s for the most part this afternoon. It was upper 50s to the north and west, and we touched 70 officially in Lafayette. Now it's 67, 69 New Iberia, and a little bit cooler again off to the north and west. Alexandria at 59. Meanwhile, southeast Louisiana basking in the mid to upper 70s, even a few 80 degree readings this afternoon. Offshore, choppy to rough out here. It's going to stay that way as the winds freshen up overnight tonight. High pressure banks in aloft from the east. That means we'll start off with mostly cloudy skies, maybe a little fog and mist overnight tonight, like what we saw last night. And then by tomorrow lunchtime, the clouds break up. We go to partly sunny skies, and then the model is suggesting mostly sunny conditions for tomorrow afternoon as temperatures top out in the 70s. Could see clouds trying to come back in a little bit for tomorrow night into early Friday, but we'll go partly sunny early Friday. Some showers late in the day. Those showers developing late mid-afternoon. They will be moving to the northwest, but for the most part, it doesn't look like a washout for Friday night football, and it looks okay for the weekend, although we do have some scattered showers for Saturday. Temperatures tonight dropping down into the upper 50s, northern and western sections of Acadiana, down on the I-10 corridor will be in the lower 60s, and pretty much lower 60s coastal parishes, mid-60s toward Franklin and also by Cameron as you get closer to the water and into the marsh. Then tomorrow, temperatures after that cool start should get into the mid to upper 70s. Most of Acadiana off to the north and west, a little bit cooler, lower 70s at Ville Platte. And then as we go into tomorrow night, Friday morning, we'll see temperatures get back down into the lower 60s. And then Friday afternoon, back into the 80s. But the next front on the way for Saturday, so we should be cooler going into the weekend. So another cool, dampish night out there. Some fog or mist possible. That northeast breeze will continue. 62 the low, with those showers that we mentioned earlier diminishing within the next hour or two. Morning clouds tomorrow, mostly sunny for the afternoon, and we'll see milder temperatures for sure. 77 the projected high. Moving ahead into Friday, not a bad way to finish off the week if you like temperatures in the 80s. Cooling off this weekend big time, nice and cool for Sunday with highs upper 60s to lower 70s, and we could still see upper 40s come Monday morning, and then a series of wet weather systems Tuesday, Wednesday. I write about it on the latest KTC.com article, which you can get that way or through our social media accounts.
All righty. Thank you, Rob.